Hi, welcome to Eritech Solutions. Let's see one simple application on microcontroller. Text display on LCD using Bluetooth wireless communication. So this application I'm trying to implement with microcontroller with different hardware modules. So I'm just taking one simple power supply unit, which is DC power supply section, which contains different voltages, 12 volts, 5 volts, 3.3 volts. So here I'm taking 5 volts supply because the other modules, most of the devices here working with 5 volts operating voltage. So the two lines I'm taking here, which is one is VCC and second one is ground. And the second hardware unit, which is microcontroller board. So here I'm using one 8051 microcontroller, which contains 40 pins. So this microcontroller contains 4 I/O ports, port 0, port 1, port 2 and port 3. So you can use any one of these ports for your applications. So this microcontroller required some external components, which are crystal oscillator. So I'm just connected across 18 and 19 pin to ceramic capacitors, which filter the noise. And across 9th pin, I just given reset button. So use it to reset your microcontroller based on application status. And also which requires resistor and capacitor combination. And this is a built-in power supply section. And here I'm not using this built-in power supply. So I used external power module. So this is not working. And the other module hardware unit, which is HC05 Bluetooth. So this is our wireless module. So which supports serial communication with 4 standard lines, RX, TX, VCC, ground. So the connection is very clear with microcontroller, RX, Bluetooth module. I am trying to give to TXD pin of microcontroller, and Bluetooth module TX pin I am trying to give to RXD pin of microcontroller. And the other two lines you have to give it to power supply, VCC and ground. So this is the simple hardware connection required between Bluetooth module and microcontroller board. So next, the other hardware unit, which is text screen 16x2 LCD. So this 16x2 LCD contains 16 standard pins. The first two pins are power supply, VCC and ground. The first pin is ground and second pin is 5 volts operating voltage pin. And the third pin, so if you are looking to adjust the contrast, you need to connect one variable resistor. I just given external variable resistor connection across third pin. So whereas the variator pin from this variable resistor, one pin is variator and other two pins are VCC and ground. So this variator pin I given to third pin from the LCD. And the two pins, one is given to VCC and other one is given to ground. Next three pins, RS, RW enabled. So these three are the three control pins from LCD. So which works based on your command, whether you are sending command to LCD or data to LCD, that will be differentiated by your RS control pin. And RW control pin working is which allows to do whether you are doing read operation or write operation with LCD. And enable pin, you have to make sure enable pin high to low once for every change of data. The next 8 lines from 7 to 14. So 7 to 14 are data lines from LCD screen. So these data lines supports to send commands or text. And the last two pins, 15 and 16 pins, which are for backlight support. If you are trying to get your text on night times, so you need to operate your backlight pins. So this backlight support I given directly to VCC and ground. So one end is backlight VCC and another one is backlight ground. So I just shorted with this VCC and ground pins. So this VCC and ground connection I given to this board VCC and ground, and RS RW pin connections given to P3.7, P3.6, P3.5 pins from the controller board. And data lines I given to one complete port, which is port 2 from microcontroller. So finally I used Bluetooth connections for RXD and TXD pins, which are the alternative functions of P3.0 and P3.1 pins. And data lines given to port 2 and LCD control pins given to 3.6, 3.7, 3.5. Let's see the hardware output. I just power on my board. So this is my initial text. I did programming, enter input data on LCD screen. So you have to provide your data through mobile phone. So, but you have to do some necessary action with a mobile phone. So just download one Bluetooth terminal app from the Play Store. So this HC05 terminal app you need to download from the Play Store. Just type HC05. So you'll get some list of applications which are freely available. So just select your Bluetooth terminal HC05 app. So in this mobile, which is already installed, so you need to, if you are new, try to install this app. So once you install the app, so you'll get home screen like this. So it will show you the default Bluetooth devices around you. So if you are new, just scan your new devices which are available around you. So which clearly shows you with the address. So you have to search for the devices. So which is already paired with HC05. If you are new, then try to give it the default password 1234. So then it supports to take the data. So now, after pairing your devices, just click on your HC05 name and try to provide your inputs. So now I'm giving a character N from the mobile phone and send ASCII so that you'll get a proper character on the screen. Again, I'm giving new character A. So I got the new character A, and again I'm trying to give N. So I'm giving the new character D and the next character A. So this is my name I displayed on LCD. And whatever the text like this you are trying to display, so you can pass it through your mobile phone. So I'm giving my continuous characters. So like this, you can prepare your own applications through this Bluetooth module as notice boards. So there are many applications you can do with this simple Bluetooth communication, wireless notice boards. Even you can apply the same concept for big displays. Okay, thanks for watching. This is a simple application.